Shut them down. Yeah, yo, smoke up, yo.
Shut them down, shut them down, shut them down.
Yeah.
Shut them down, shut them down, shut them down.
Start the balance, we wildin', wildin'. Swing rappers, body found, washed up on Coney Island. When I rolled up, this nigga hard slowed up. That killer froze up. When I pulled up, jumped out with the pump, I 32 shots and ducked out. Then I broke out, left that cat for dead. His body smoked out, cause in the fallout, that killer's that kill me, kid. I'm going all out. Life's a bitch, fuck it. Got the gun, bust it. The game play, gotta play by the rules of your own, cannot be trusted. Don't try to test, surprise your chest with five inside your vest. Every lane with a death rest, should've known when you was looking in the eyes of death. Ask Lord for forgiveness, when I did this, there was not no witness, but he should understand. Cause even God got a shitless.
Today, I want to talk about timing in spiritual work. But the timing I'm going to talk about today is not in regards to how long something takes, but more in regards to when you should commence to doing work. Because there's times where people, they just figure, I'm going to do work, you know, and that's just going to be it. Well, let's just say this. We can take this into a transcendental level, and we can look at this and realize that each day of the week corresponds to a planet. We have... Now, I'm not going to go in English because English is kind of fucked up and you really won't see it. You have Lunzi, which is basically lunar. Maozi, which is Mars. Mekwurzi, which is Mercury. Jurzi, Jupiter. Vendredi, Venus. Samzi, Saturday. Dimash, well, that kind of falls off. But in English, you have it, it's pretty much Sunday. You know, Saturday, Saturn. You know, so we can go into this big break, this big makeup of how the days correspond to different forces, and we can go even into the planetary hours. But I'm going to make this very simple today. And I want to keep this in a place where all can understand. Timing. When is the best time to do work? Now, I'm going to give different scenarios. I had a statement that I made years ago. I said, if your case is over 6 months, I don't want to do the work. If you call me up to ask me to do works and you haven't seen your lover for over 6 months, I would say, you know what? I'm not even going to take that case. Why? Because the time period has created so much distance that the repossession of that person is going to take a lot of time. I say 6 months and over, I don't want to touch the case. Again, because the repossession, the pulling of that person is going to take a lot of time. And with this lot of time, most people cannot deal. Most people cannot handle sitting still and doing absolutely nothing. Now, what would be preferable would be someone that you've recently separated from to do work on. Because if you separated from the person and it's been recent, the emotions are still there for the forces to manipulate. When someone is far away in time from you, when you do work on that person, this forces is going to put things in that person's way or put things in that person's mind to make them reflect about the past. But the question is, how long does that take? It takes a pretty damn long time. Where per se, if you do work on someone that's you've had a month, two, three, you know, y'all been separated, it's going to be much easier for you to pull a target. Because it's, you know, because it's the distance and the time frame, it's manageable. So I say in regards to this aspect of working, it becomes very important to know your deadline. So if you're dealing with someone, it would be wise to start your work after a bit of seeing this person. Like, let's just say, you know, if you want to prevent this guy from leaving, I would say give it a month or so. Feel the guy out, feel how things is, and you feel like, you know what, or a woman whatsoever, if you feel as a woman, you feel in that person, whatever, then you do what you have to do. Don't wait until you fucking break up and it's been like, you know, you break up and you separate for whatever reason and you didn't reach out to the person. Y'all just fucking stop talking for about a whole fucking year or 5 years and now you figure you want to do work now? No. For me, it's too late. Maybe somewhere else. If someone will take your case, but I doubt they'll give you what the fuck you're looking for. Scenario number two. If you want to be low-key, under the radar, when would be the best time to strike an enemy? You know, you don't want to be known. You don't want to be suspected. You know, you don't want to, you know, necessarily be considered or thought of as being the person who put whatever work out. See, the times of mass hysteria and mass confusion is a time to do your wickedness. Because in the hour of darkness, everyone's a suspect. So now you have someone that you've had problems with. Everything was transpiring at one point in time. And, you know, there was really everything was on, all the spotlights were on your situation. But now, the moment of darkness, the hour of darkness, comes upon a person's scenario, life, or situation. Now, whoever they're in the situation as of now, quarantine. When you're doing work, especially when you're doing work in regards to breaking individuals up, doing love work, what happens in times like this is the individual. I'm going to give it to you in different ways. So you got love work. I'm going to go into the destruction part, but you have love work going on. The person doesn't have distractions. When the person's out there in a move and everything's going on, they're going here, they're going there, whatsoever, their mind is distracted. They have a lot of things to, you know, distract their mind. But now, when they're confined to a situation where they're jobless, they're at home, they don't have nothing to focus on except their inner thoughts. So now they're not around anyone. So now the work begins to creep up on them, creep up on them. And now they start thinking, having pondering thoughts about you. But now I'm going to move off of this because my focus right here is destruction. Now you have two people that you're doing breakup work on and they're congregated in the same home. Congregated in the same house. What begins to happen is that all those vices that were not present become present because now they're up close. It's like having glasses on. Some people can see far away and some people can't. But now, when you put your glasses on, now you can understand the situation much better. You can see what's in front of you. So it's the same way when you have two people that are separated, that are at a distance. They don't know much about one another until they come close to one another and are around one another. Have you ever experienced this where you were with a person and, you know, everything was great, but then as soon as you moved in together, everything went to fucking hell. Why is that? Because now you get to know the true person. You don't know a person until you're living with them. And that is when you can determine whether this person, I can tolerate them or not. So with that said, know the time. Time is of the essence.
Shut them down. Yeah, yo, swing up, yo.
Shut them down, shut them down, shut them down. Shut them down, shut them down, shut them down. Shut them down, shut them down, shut them down. Shut them down.
Shut them down, start the violence. We wildin', swing rappers, body found, washed up on Coney Island.